6 Matrix-level technologies developing in real life. Delivered almost 20 years ago, the Matrix has proceeded to turn into a social phenomenon beyond the sci-fi sort. While it was for the most part considered science fiction at that point, it promoted the simulation hypothesis, the possibility that we as a whole are living inside a virtual experience. We are quite a separation away from a Matrix-level human-computer interaction, yet there are a few advancements that will ultimately empower such real factors. Let's go through those advancements. Number 6. Matrix-style armbands transformed humans into batteries. Specialists at the University of Colorado in Boulder have made a harmless-to-the-ecosystem device that uses human body hotness and converts it to energy. Tech lovers could control their own watches or wellness trackers by wearing a stretchy ring or armband containing thermoelectric chips that convert heat into electrical energy, as indicated by research distributed in the Diary of Science Advances. The concept may sound like something out of the Matrix film series, in which a race of robots have enslaved humans to harvest their precious organic energy. Thermoelectric gadgets can give consistent capacity to wearable gadgets and might actually implant batteries later on, said the paper's senior creator, Xianlang Xiao, to the Thomas Reuters Foundation in the emails. We trust this invention could, undoubtedly, somewhat, take care of the pollution issues of the electronic waste, he said, adding the tool is completely recyclable. The device generates about 1 volt of energy per square centimeter of skin. Number 5. Building replicators and holodeck via Matrix technology. An early manifestation of the holodeck first showed up in the scene of Star Trek, the animated series, in 1974, and was called an entertainment room, but it was the next generation that completely brought the storytelling of the 24th century holodeck to life. As the holodeck first showed up, individuals thought about what it would take to make one in actuality. McIntosh clarifies that it would require the floor underneath you to ascend to make steps, put together itself into the harsh surface of wood as you brush past a fence, and reconfigure itself to feel like fur as a cat passed by. The replicator may deal with a subatomic base, which is adequate to make food or articles for day-by-day use. Much of the time, reused matter can be utilized for replication. The main motivation behind why the replicator may be further developed is that the replicator formula is forever put away. Though carrier designs are moved continuously, if this trend continues, pretty soon, like Captain Picard, you'll be able to say, "Tea, Earl Grey, hot," and have it fabricated right before your eyes. Number 4. Mind interfaces and implanted memories. Presently, we should move past where we are today into a more theoretical region. One of the primary reasons the Matrix was so attractive to people like Neo was that the pictures were radiated straightforwardly into their cerebrums, for this situation through a wire that connected to the cerebral cortex. Essentially, the cerebrum was fooled into thinking the experience was genuine. Neo then, at that point, woke up in a case with a wire into his cerebral cortex, which was answerable for sending pictures to his cerebrum and recording his reactions. Propels made somewhat recently propose that mind interfaces are not as distant as we might suspect. New businesses in this field incorporate Neurable, which is chipping away at BCI, brain-computer interfaces, for controlling things inside virtual reality using only your psyche. As of late, a group of scientists from the University of Washington and Carnegie Mellon had the option to utilize skull covers and cerebrum waves to send data concerning how to move a Tetris piece between 3 players. 2 who could see the screen and 1 who couldn't, adequately an electronic type of telepathy. Number 3. Downloadable consciousness. Totally absurd and unreal Matrix, but it's going to be true. One of the heads of transhumanist development, Google futurist Ray Kurzweil, accepts that we are moving toward the uniqueness in both incredibly smart AI, what's more, in another manner, downloading consciousness to silicon-based gadgets, saving our brains for eternity. deepfake photos are being produced by AI, which are undefined from genuine photos, and a video went viral of the latest AI eliminating vehicles from scenes with pretty surprising outcomes. In 2013, a group of analysts at MIT, while investigating Alzheimer's, discovered that they could install memories into the minds of mice, and these memories wound up having similar neural construction as genuine memories. The individuals who accept this think that we should simply copy neurons and neural associations of the cerebrum, which would be 1,012 neurons through 1,015 neurotransmitters. Kurzweil thinks we'll be there by 2045. Most of the world's religions, Eastern and Western traditions, already teach of transmission of consciousness, downloading it at birth, and uploading it at the death of the body. Number 2. Linking brain and computers. The present best Cerebrum PC interface frameworks resemble two supercomputers trying to talk to one another using an old 300 baud modem. The Examination Office's Neural Engineering System Design, NESD, want to develop an embedded gadget that would fill in as an interpreter, changing over between electrochemical language utilized by neurons in the cerebrum and the ones and zeros that establish language of data. You might review in the science fiction film The Matrix, heroes were connected to a savage virtual future world via cerebrum interface. Philip Avelda, the NESD program chief, said, "Among the program's potential applications are gadgets that could make up for shortages in sight or hearing by taking care of advanced hearable and visual data into the cerebrum at a goal and quality far higher than is possible with current technology." The NESD program means to create frameworks that can convey obviously with any of dependent upon 1 million neurons in a given area of the cerebrum, Alveda expressed. Number 1. Turning off the sun. The most unbelievable sci-fi thing going to happen is creating a dark storm that can cover the sun completely. A gathering of Harvard researchers intends to handle environmental change through geoengineering by shutting out the sun. The idea of misleadingly reflecting daylight has been around for quite a long time, yet this will be the first genuine effort to control Earth's temperature through a sunlight-based designing. The technique for shutting out daylight has been dubious in established researchers for quite a long time. The controversy lies in the failure to completely know what outcomes to some degree shutting out daylight would include. A decrease in worldwide temperature is surely known and expected. There remains inquiries around this current technique's effect on rain designs, the ozone, and crop yields universally. To Matrix lovers, this is going to be an apocalypse, as in Matrix movie. Scientists searching for any method for easing back their development to block the sun's beams from the outer layer of the Earth, utilizing nanites splashed into the upper climate with expectations of cutting the machines off from their essential power source. What do you think would happen with the Matrix technology coming to reality? Subscribe to us for more information of unbelievable things that are going to happen sooner or later.